York City is the greatest city in the world. Where else can you see a concert on the subway on your way to another concert?
Jesus is the only one who can lead you to God. No one else can do this. No pope, no bishop, no rabbi, no minister. Only Jesus can lead you to God. Jesus will be coming back in the year 1999.
Jesus who? You mean Jesus Lizard? They aren't coming in 1999. They played Roseland last week. Besides, how can you possibly get concert information that far in advance?
Armageddon is around the corner, my friend.
Armageddon is playing Irving Plaza on the 14th. Here, take this. It sounds like you need it.
Here's a quarter.
Take a ride. Take a ride.
I called the Guinness Book of World Records and they weren't interested. They said if you eat 176 snails in an hour, give us a call. They have categories for who could throw a cow turd the farthest and the loudest pig call, but no category for concerts.
Thank you. always into music. We bought him a guitar when he was 7, but...
My brother was always taking it so I could never practice. He's a professional musician now. He's taken a lot of concerts. You've seen Frank Sinatra, Buddy Rich, Tony Bennett. You never saw a dead show with me, you know.
Yeah, I used to say I'll be grateful when they're dead. I was furious when he missed his high school graduation tour.
Frank Zappa was playing at the Fillmore, and it was closing that week. So I made the decision to go. It was only my second concert, the first time I ever waited on long for a show. I saw the Birds the month before that at Carnegie Hall. It was my first concert. And then I saw the New Eyes at a Purple Sage a week later.
And once he started going into concerts, though, we didn't see very much of him.
Can you believe that this guy has seen 8,000 concerts and he didn't see me at Woodstock?
And I always thought it was odd that he would like pay to get in and stay for 20 minutes, but then that's because he was rushing off to another show.
Joe's probably the only person that ever took out a student loan, and what he did with it is he bought concert tickets.
Joe will come in, and if the mood hits him right, he'll spark up a big fat J and pass it around and, you know, watch the band, and in intervals he'll talk about all the other great shows he saw that night or that week.
Hey, Joe, how did you come up with the idea for the buzzer?
Well, I never had the incentive to really chase a frisbee, so I used to take a pita bread from Pierre's Falafel on 69th Street, pop a hole through the center, stick a joint through, light it up, throw it back and forth, catch it, take a bite, take a toke. Eventually, I came up with the Busby. You take a Frisbee, put a pipe in the center, you throw it back and forth, goes farther and straighter than any Frisbee in the world. Every time you catch it, you take a tote, the cops come, and you just throw it away.
See, in High Times, he's a legend for one thing, and in the rock world, he's a legend for another thing. He's being the Guinness Book of World Records for most creative pipe making or something.
So, Joe, who's this guy in the picture anyway? I ain't never seen him before.
That's Vinny the Guinea.
Yeah?
I remember I was riding in a car with him once, and he pulled out a heroin needle and stabbed his mother. Then he tried to kill himself by jumping off the roof, wound up breaking both legs.
Unbelievable.
Then he pushes his wheelchair off the roof twice and survives. Finally, the ambulance driver comes up to him and says, Jesus, you again? Don't you know you gotta jump at least 5 stories if you wanna kill yourself? He could have done a 4th floor.
And they do snap. And the only way and the easiest way out for them is to jump off a building. You know, and then 90% of them too are on drugs, they're on crack, they're on dope, you know, they're on hallucinogens.
Where's Eric the Red?
He got his car towed, he's trying to get it back.
Joe, seen any good shows lately?
I saw Gina at Goldfinger's.
Oh shit, I didn't know strip clubs had bands.
Hey Joe. How many stories up are we? So what's going on with Angela now?
Who knows? Jerry, give me some sort of sign if I should continue with my quest.
It's bad enough. You gotta go up to see music every night, but you have to turn my sculpture into a concert too? God. Oof.
Angela, I have to admit, that was the best vegetarian meal I've ever tasted. It's been a while since you cooked.
Well, maybe next Sunday I could make that.
Angela, next Sunday.
Oh, right. Next Sunday is Bad Brains at the Continental. How could I forget? You know, we have got to make some more room for Jesse. You've got to get rid of some of this stuff.
Hey, you can't throw that out. That's the only shirt of its kind in the world. That's it. I got no choice but to go out now. Whalers at SOBs, Tony Bennett at Lincoln Center, Falafel Mafia at CBGB's, and the best unsigned band in the city, the Screamin Headless Torsos, is playing tonight. Have fun watching reruns of Murphy Brown.
You walk out that door, you had better not come back.
I'm going home, yes, I'm going home, back to my wife, I'll stay with her.
with you.
Yeah, as a critic, I'll usually go to 4 or 5 shows a week, and there's always, Joe's always there in his tie-dye shirt, pipe around his neck, and I've kind of missed that there. It's good to talk to him, but ever since that thing happened with his wife, haven't seen him around anymore. It's too bad.
I have seen him recently a few times. There may have been a gap prior to the last few times I've seen him and the times before that.
He's definitely curtailed his concert going because of the marriage.
With Joe, everything has to be the biggest, the best. The best city in the world, the best unsigned band in the city, the best pipe in the world. Do you know he's taken classes for more than 30 years? Yeah. Yeah, he has 365 credits to his name, and he doesn't graduate until this summer. Mm-hmm. Oh, and he wants the biggest diploma and the bested cover band to play the graduation. Oh, he's earned a degree in aerospace engineering, of all things.
So he likes to go to a lot of rock concerts. Well, I guess we all have our pet peeves. Tell me, how many did you see last week, or last month, let's say?
I saw over 1,000 last year.
Oh, I see.
1,031. I broke the unofficial world record. I went from seeing 20 shows a week to 6 after we were married. I would say that's making a sacrifice.
Get your facts straight if you're gonna argue with me. You see 8 or 9 shows a week, not 6.
I'd like to see you go from smoking 2 packs to 10 cigarettes a day. I bet you could. How am I ever supposed to win an argument with her? She's a lawyer. She argues for a living. The only show she'd ever see with me is The Grateful Dead. And we can't even see them anymore. Music is dead.
Yeah, right. Not for you, it isn't. And on top of that, get a look at this. He expects me to wear this.
What is that?
It's a bikini of Jones. What else?
Yeah, this is boring.
Come on! I don't know why he said that. Do you?
I don't know either. Sensei, wrong song?
Hey, you know any other Dead songs? I've been to over 400 shows, you know. They were the best band there ever was.
Yeah, I know a bunch. Yeah, how about this?
Hey, what time is this gig end? There's a lot of good bands playing tonight. Pigs from Hell and Guar.
Aren't they the band that throws fake blood at the audience?
Yeah, I think I'll go see them last so I can clean up after the show.
Hey, how many times I gotta tell you guys not to set up around here? Get out of here!
Sorry, I'm out.
Because you're civilized! You get brutalized! You're so civilized, man, I see you!
Hey, you can't come to Pigs from Hell!
So you hippies think you can smoke and know wherever you please, huh?
Hey, you guys are great tonight.
Yeah, have a hit.
I want
wonder what you're like without the
guy. Hey, that's the best suite in New York. Guys ain't even signed yet. Don't you think you're a little too bold? Hey, Joe. I don't think these guys are the pigs from hell.
Hey, what did you call us?
You take life just another day to me. You think you're different, but you're just another pig. You gotta have a gun. You're a pig to me, just a pig to me.
In other news, a bizarre chain of events unfolded this evening. There apparently was an altercation between two groups of New York City police officers. One group, apparently in cahoots with this man, assaulted another group of officers. An amateur camera person was able to capture some of the events on a home video camera.
Angela! 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 Angela!
Young Joe started breaking records early on in life. It was a family tradition of sorts. His father held the record for the most days worked without a sick day at Rizzo's garbage disposal. Little Joe, well, he cracked the record for the most papers delivered in a one-year period. I guess you could say this is where his obsessive compulsive behavior started. He'd get on that bike and ride from dawn to dusk. It was on this very paper route he found his first radio.
Mrs. Sorelli, you think you could take a look at this for me? Guess you can get it to work.
Sure, Joe, let me have a look.
Thanks.
Information Station, Radio 710, WOR.
Yes, life's full of decisions, little guy. Anyway, is that radio of yours? Looks fine, though.
What kind of decisions, Mrs. Sorelli?
Joe, like the ones you just made. You know, music versus women, women versus fun with the guys, women versus other women. And now you got me started. Luckily, nowadays, all I gotta worry about is the pastrami versus the prosciutto.
Well, why can't you have both?
What do you mean, pastrami and prosciutto? Because
they... No, why can't you have women and other women and music?
Well, Joe, that's something you're gonna have to learn on your own.
Well, thanks for fixing the radio, Mrs. Sorelli.
No problem, Joe. Oh, congratulations on a new record.
Thanks.
Being from the old country, his dad always tried to teach him to do the right thing. He told him that the guys he idolized were all drug addicts and womanizers, but little Joe would have none of it. All he knew was that they could play guitar. Found out his father was a bit of a musician himself. He was a pretty big folk singer back in the old country, but had to put his dreams aside when he moved here and had to support a family.
Sometimes after work, he'd pull out these old Sultan outfits and put them on over his Dickies work clothes. He'd pull out a poncho blanket and put it on our bed and sit and play guitar. Being a working class schmo never really sat right with him. After all these years, I finally realized he was pretty damn good. I just wish I had a chance to tell him that. It is in his memory that I devoted myself to the appreciation of music.
City is the greatest city in the world and the only city that Joe would ever live in. Where else could he see a concert on the subway on the way to another concert?
Jesus is the only one who can lead you to God. No one else can do this. No pope, no bishop, no rabbi, no minister. Only Jesus can lead you to God. Jesus will be coming back in the year 1999.
Jesus who? You mean Jesus Lizard? They aren't coming in 1999. They played Roseland last week. Besides, how can you possibly get concert information that far in advance?
Armageddon is around the corner, my friend.
Armageddon is playing Irving Plaza on the 14th. Here, take this. It sounds like you need it.
Here's a quarter.
Take a ride. 38-year-old unemployed construction worker from Brooklyn, New York, is asking the Guinness Book of World Records to start a new category for most concerts attended in 1 year. Last year, Concert Joe attended 1,031 shows, an average of 3 per night.
Joe called the Guinness Book in the midst of his quest. They told him if he could eat 176 snails in an hour to give him a call. They have a category for who could throw a cow turd the farthest, but no category for concerts. You'd figure they'd establish a new category for a freak like him.
I got the world's smallest violin.
It's my assignment to follow these freaks in order to learn more about Concert Joe. These are some of Concert Joe's cronies. That's Ronnie on the left. I guess you could say he's the Renaissance man of the group. He doesn't restrict himself to one form of debauchery. He sees at least one concert, play, or movie every night. That's Jean-Claude in the middle. He's Joe's Eurotrash friend who can get anything, anytime, from any part of the world. He's a connoisseur of fine wine and music, and he tries to add a little culture to this motley crew. Spike's Johnson on the end with all the tattoos, the major league pitching prospect that had the habit of exposing himself during games. A compulsive flasher with a 95-mile-an-hour fastball.
Hey, nice playing.
And when you get knocked on your fucking ass, I got the world's smallest violin.
Always into music. We bought him a guitar when he was 7, but
my brother was always taking it, so I could never practice. He's a professional musician now. He's taking a lot of concerts. You've seen Frank Sinatra, Buddy Rich, Tony Bennett. He never saw a dead show with me, you know.
Yeah, I used to say I'll be grateful when they're dead. I was furious when he missed his high school graduation tour.
Frank Zappa was playing at the Fillmore, and it was closing that week. So I made the decision to go. It was only my second concert, the first time I ever waited on long for a show. I saw the Birds the month before that at Carnegie Hall. It was my first concert. And then I saw the New Eyes at a Purple Sage a week later.
And once he started going into concerts, though, we didn't see very much of him.
Because you're civilized, you get broke. so civilized, man, I see you.
Hey, you can't come to me from hell.
You're so civilized.
So you hippies think you can smoke your nose wherever you please, eh?
Hey, you guys are great tonight.
You have a hit.
I wonder what you're like without the gun.
Hey, that's the best weed in New York. Guys ain't even signed yet. Don't you think you're a little too bold? Hey, Joe, I don't think these guys are the pigs from hell.
Hey, what did you call us?
You take life just another day to me.
Mother!
Kick it!
You're
not
bigger than Richie
King! Give me that! Just another pig to me. You think you're different, but you're just another pig. You gotta have a gun. You're a pig to me. Just a pig to me.
You're
just another pig!
In other news, a bizarre chain of events unfolded this evening. There apparently was an altercation between two groups of New York City police officers. One group, apparently in cahoots with this man, assaulted another group of officers. An amateur camera person was able to capture some of the events on a home video camera.
The wife locked him out that night. He wanted to spend the night at Bobby Nez's. The only problem was that Bobby was still out on the road. I've seen some real alcoholics in my day, but this guy takes the cake. He's very precise in his preparation. This guy has a martini glass set between the handlebars of his Harley. He brings all the ingredients, olives, strainer, the whole deal, and he pours himself a martini before every ride. He also rode with what the other freaks called his life preserver. It was a flak jacket filled with airplane bottles of booze from JD, tequila, Bacardi, to Hennessy. You name it, he had it. I've learned that every one of these freaks has his own ritual. This kook would start out with a few bottles from his life preserver, then the martini, and then wash it down with some beer that he kept in his Camelback.
I guess there is something worth buying from L.L. Bean after all.
Bobby was a real fixture at the Jones Beach concerts during the summer. This stooge calls himself Yafim. He claims to be an Orthodox rabbi. A little basic research unearthed the real story. He's a con man and a polygamist who ripped off three women in the past year alone. The other members of the crew simply referred to him as the rock and roll rabbi. Even in the mosh pit, he never seems to lose his yarmulke. This wasn't the first time Tommy Lydell had gotten kicked out of a club. Only this time, it happened to be one of the best rock and roll clubs in the city. His rap sheet included 14 counts of drunken driving. It's a miracle he's still alive riding that English racing bike around town in a perpetual drunken stupor. Of course, he knew this rock and roll rabbi character.
That fucking wanker Giuliani. Can't even fucking well get a drink down here.
You think you got a bed? Today's a Sabbath. I'm not even supposed to be riding this thing.
Hey, give me a shot of that. Cheers, mate.
You know, these freaks had nothing else in common except for their love of booze and pure speed. Here we have Shveta Polotska, an elderly Polish woman who is revered by the other freaks. She's seen more operas than anyone alive. She's also notorious for smelling up the back of the Metropolitan Opera House with her Polish kielbasa she smuggles inside. I'm surprised she doesn't ride around on a Harley, too. Here I was, trailing Joe again. He stumbled upon this unruly bunch of protesters. There's a whole world of desperate, demented concert junkies and freak ticket scalpers out there. They share this weird synergy. They make each other's lives a little bit easier. Here we see a new generation of freaks at the Grateful Dead shows of the early 90s on Earth. This is their new outlet for musical and communal warmth with their fellow freaks. This is the time of night when the worldwide network of concert junkies converge on stadiums, concert halls, and rundown bars to get their fix of music and communion with their fellow freak brothers.
This man has seen everybody play in town, man, you know?
where these people have taken to the streets to protest Congress's hearing of the impeachment inquiry.
Who cares if, he cheats on his wife, gets out of town a little while, you know? I mean, let the man get back to his job.
It's crazy. I mean, you can't trust him. He's ruining everything. If he could do this to the president, then he could do this to anybody, you know? I mean, what the heck? I mean, you know?
Yeah. Bam.
Yes, it's outrageous. It's a farce. Ken Starr is wasting the taxpayers' money. The government should be doing its work. Ken Starr should be ashamed of himself.
Sir, what's your take on Ken Starr and the president's handling of this situation?
I don't know much about it, except that the guy's obsessed with the president's sex life.
If he could do it to the president, you know, he could do it to all of us.
You got a point there.
Yeah, you're damn right, I got a point.
But actually, I'm just here for the music. See, I'm trying to get in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most concerts in 1 year. I think that's more important than all this.
There you have it. Ken Starr, impeachment, and the Guinness Book, all here at 26 Federal Plaza. Back to you, Bill.
His wife locked him out again that night. He wound up at Spike's place.
Who's this guy in the picture anyway? I've never seen him before.
That's Vinny the Guinea.
Yeah?
I remember I was riding in a car with him once, and he pulled out a heroin needle and stabbed his mother.
Ooh.
Then he tried to kill himself by jumping off the roof.
He wound up breaking both legs. Then he pushes his wheelchair off the roof twice and survives. Finally, the ambulance driver comes up to him and says, "Jesus, you again? Don't you know you gotta jump at least 3 stories if you want to kill yourself?" He lived on the second floor.
And they do snap. And the only way and the easiest way out for them is to jump off a building. You know, and then 90% of them too are on drugs, they're on crack, they're on dope, you know, they're on hallucinogenics.
Hey Joe, how many stories up are we? So what's going on with Angela now?
Have fun watching reruns of Murphy Brown.
You walk out that door, you had better not come back.
I'm going home. Yes, I'm going home.
Guy finally broke the record tonight. No small feat. It's something he's been working towards for almost 10 years. 10 years of blood, sweat, and preparation. And
yet there was something missing. There was something very hollow about the whole thing. Sure, he had solidified his status as a cult hero, Concert Joe, world record holder, but it all seemed pretty vacant without Angela. For the first time in his life, he had found an anchor, and now it looked like it was gone. He was free to roam the streets again, but he had an experience worthy of comparing his passion for music to, and he was torn. This guy wanted to have his cake and eat it too. That doesn't wash with a female corporate lawyer type in the 90s. Okay, she used to be a hippie. That was then. But on the other hand, what the hell did she expect? She married Concert Joe. Life is full of decisions, big guy. Which one are you gonna make? Or has it already been made for you? Carson Adler, Guinness Book of World Records, my friend.
We're gonna make you famous. Come on, guy. We're gonna write your story. Look here, why don't you tell me how it all began? Well, back in 67, I set a record for delivering the most newspapers.
When the curtain rises on the show, there becomes a whole new reality for Concert Joe.
Can you believe that this guy has seen 8,000 concerts and he didn't see me at Woodstock?
Yeah, as a critic, I'll usually go to four or five shows a week, and there's always, Joe's always there, and it's tie-dye shirt, pipe around his neck, and I've kind of missed that there. It's good to talk to him, but ever since that thing happened with his wife, I haven't seen him around anymore. It's too bad.
I have seen him recently a few times. There may have been a gap prior to the last few times I've seen him and the times before that, but that might be a reflection of me too, because I've been involved in a lot of projects that have kind of kept me out of the scene a bit.
He would just come to my shows about catch the end of the set, like 15, 20 minutes, tell me he's great, great, and then he would say something like, this is my sixth show tonight, and I'm gonna catch two more before the night is over, you know? So he'd come to Milo Z and get funked up, and then he'd come down to Nightingales and, you know, catch what was going on over here.
You know, Joe will come in and, you know, watch the band and, you know, in intervals he'll talk about all the other great shows he saw that night or that week, and it's just, the man is obsessed.
And I always thought it was odd that he would, like, pay to get in and stay for 20 minutes, but then that's because he was rushing off to another show.